Hi folks, Will from MinIO here. This is going to be the second of our demonstrations. And in this demonstration, we're going to get into writing a custom policy. This is going to help fill the gap between the various policies that come built into MinIO. Let's go ahead and dive right in. Now, at this stage, you may be thinking to yourself, well, there's a pretty big gap between read-write and read-only. I mean, read-only, I'd like people to be able to list objects. You know, it's not like I'm giving out a bunch of information and letting people write objects. So I want to close that gap a little ways. And what we can do is we can set up a custom policy, and then I can apply multiple policies to my group, and then all of the different policies will be put together, and the group can then use all those different functions that are part of the multiple policies. Now, one thing to keep in mind, when I'm working with multiple policies, deny takes precedence over allow. So I have to explicitly allow, and anything that I don't explicitly allow is automatically denied. So that's a very powerful tool that you can use for the system as well. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to create a new policy. I already have a policy JSON file, which I'll show you here. This policy JSON allows me to list buckets. It has this list star as well, so I can list everything. And it's notably only the list tools that I'm doing here. I'm not adding any other allows. They're not allowed to write. They're not allowed to do anything else. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add this policy as a new policy in my MinIO IDP. Let me go ahead and clear this. So MC admin policy create MinIO 1, and my policy name is going to be called lister, and it's going to be from this policy JSON. There we go. So there is my policy lister, has been created successfully. If I do an MC admin policy list on MinIO 1, well, there it is. Lister is now part of my collection of policies that I have available on my system. So what I want to do now is I want to attach this one to the browser's group. I don't want to attach it just to the user. That's why I set up the group in the first place. So MC admin policy attach MinIO 1 lister, and this is going on the group browsers. Okay, so I have now attached lister to the group browsers. If I do an MC admin group info MinIO 1 browsers, I can see that I have the policy read only and lister. Now remember, new user is already part of this group. So let's go back to the console. And as you can see, we still have my bucket IAM has two objects in it, but now if I click on this, I have the ability to list, so I can list items. I cannot upload anything. That would be writing a new object, and I can't do that. But I can list my objects now, so I can actually see them. I can get information. I can download this one, for instance, because I have that ability. But notice I have a lot of items here that I do not have the ability to change. I can't put legal holds on this, for instance. I can't change this object in any way. I can't put any object tagging on this. So there are very fine-grained permissions, and by having these multiple policies that maybe control one or another small permission set, I can collect them together on a group. I can even collect them together on a user if I want to. And this will allow me to have very clear control over what a user can do on my system. So that's how you can manage users and groups using the MinIO IDP. Now, if your company is already using something like LDAP or OpenID, MinIO can integrate with it. And in our next video, we're going to show you how you can set up LDAP to manage all of your users and groups. I hope you've enjoyed this video so far. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can use any of the methods that you see here on the screen. If you'd like to chat with us interactively, you can chat with us on slack.min.io, or you can just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for our LDAP video.